In one narration, where are you, the one who weeps a lot? He used to weep a lot of the fear of Allah. He said, you know, come. So the man actually got on the minbar. He got on the minbar. Then look what Muawiyah radiallahu anhu did in this particular occasion. Muawiyah said, oh Allah, we are putting before us here the most righteous man that we know of. Oh Allah, give us rain. Oh Yazid. Then he said, ya Yazid, ud'u Allah. Oh Yazid, supplicate to Allah. The people who were present said, he made three dua, three. And rain started falling until they almost drowned. He made three dua, and rain started falling until they almost drowned. So what does that teach us? He said, oh Yazid, raise up your hands to Allah, and they made dua. Why did Muawiyah not go to the grave of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and say, ya Rasulullah, oh Messenger of Allah, ask Allah to give us rain. We are suffering from drought, etc., etc., etc. He didn't do that. Even the Sahaba and the Salaf understood that if you want to seek rain from Allah, he didn't do it. Oh Allah, we ask you through the jah of the Messenger of Allah. We ask you through the status of the Messenger of Allah. He said, no, no, come here, Yazid ibn al-Aswad. You come, you make dua to Allah. You raise your hands to Allah, he made dua, Allah Azza wa Jal gave him rain. What does that mean? That means that they understood that the means of tawassul was through the dua of the righteous man, not through the man himself. Through the dua of the righteous man, not through the man himself. This is clear, cannot be disputed. Now, if tawassul through Al-Abbas sufficed, why did he make dua? And if the dua through Muawiyah was sufficed, why did he ask Yazid to make dua? In both cases, Al-Abbas made dua for rain, and Yazid ibn al-Aswad made dua for rain. So you find that the idea of tawassul is revolving around what? The dua of the righteous man. Was there anyone more righteous than the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Absolutely not. So they asked him to make dua. Al-Abbas, he was the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Ahlul Bayt. And that's an honorable status. And he was a righteous man. So they used to ask Allah to give him rain through the dua of Al-Abbas. And during the time of Muawiyah, Yazid ibn al-Aswad was among the most righteous of men. So they begged Allah for rain through the dua of Yazid ibn al-Aswad. You cannot dispute that. You cannot do it. طيب. We have another narration which further reinforces and fortifies our position. And it is رواية في مستخرج الإسماعيلي. He said, كانوا إذا قحطوا على عهد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم استسقوا به فيستسقي لهم فلما كان في إمارة عمر إلى آخر الحديث. In this رواية, in الإسماعيلي, he said, whenever they used to suffer from drought, at the time of the Messenger of Allah, they used to seek rain through the Messenger of Allah, meaning he will make dua for them, and Allah will give him rain, and in the imara, in the rulership of Umar, then they did the way they did it with Al-Abbas. So what did the term they used? Yastasqu. And we all know Salatul Istisqa. When you go to Salatul Istisqa, in your dua, do you say, oh Allah, we ask you through this imam of ours to give us rain? Is that what you do? What do you do? He makes dua and we say, Ameen. He makes the dua because he's the imam. He's assumed to be righteous. You don't ask Allah, oh Allah, give us rain through this imam or through this person or through that person. That doesn't make any sense. Because that's not how they did it at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, nor the way they did it afterwards. So that terminates and closes the door for this hadith to be used as an evidence for making tawassul through the status of the Prophet ﷺ. Because they didn't do that. And I gave you the explanation. What's the other narration? The other narration is more sophisticated. Uthman ibn Hunayf said, أن رجلا ضريرا أتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا نبي الله أدعو الله. I want you to remember these Arabic words. أدعو الله أن يعافيني. أدعو الله أن يعافيني. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم إن شئت أخرت ذلك فهو خير لك وإن شئت دعوت لك قال لا بل أدعو الله لي لا بل أدعو الله لي فأمره أن يتوضأ you all know the wudu وأن يصلي ركعتين وأن يدعو بهذا الدعاء اللهم إني أتوجه إليك بنبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبي الرحمة يا محمد إني أتوجه بك إلى ربي في حاجة هذه فتقضى اللهم فشفعني فيه وشفعه في فقال ففعل الرجل فبرئ. Very dangerous. Let me give you the exact translation so you will not get caught up in the mix over here. Ahmed in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad, Sahih Hadith. Uthman ibn Hunayf said, a blind man came to the Prophet and said, Ud'u Allah li, supplicate to Allah, invoke Allah for me. He wanted what? He wanted Allah to restore his vision. He wanted Allah to give him back his vision. So he said, the Prophet ﷺ said, if you wish, I will supplicate for you. And if you wish, I will delay that, for that is better for you. If you wish, I will delay that, for that is better for you. And in the narration, if you wish, have patience, and it is better for you. Because in one hadith, Allah Azza wa Jal says in Hadith Qudsi, that the reward of, if Allah takes away the two beloved of a person, which are his two eyes, his reward is Jannah. If Allah makes someone go blind and he's a righteous believer, his reward will be Jannah. So he said, be patient, it is better for you. The man said, no, but ask Allah, supplicate to Allah, invoke Allah for me. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he ordered him to make wudu. And then he ordered him to pray two rak'at and to supplicate with the following dua. O Allah, I ask you and turn to you by means of your Prophet Muhammad. Now we will understand this. Take time out. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet of mercy. Now pay attention. O Muhammad, I have turned by means of you, meaning your dua, to my Lord in this need of mine, so that it may be fulfilled. O Allah, accept him as a supplicant on my behalf and accept my supplication for him to be accepted for me. So the man did that and he was cured. His vision was restored. So they say, he said in the dua, O Allah, I am turning to you through the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. O Messenger of Allah, I'm turning to you, you know, to Allah through you, through your dua, that such and such and such, and that it worked. طيب, let us understand this hadith in the right context according to Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. This hadith actually reinforces our earlier argument, which is he was seeking nearness to Allah through the what? The dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Reason number one. If the man wanted this particular virtue, if it was permissible to seek tawassul through the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself, what is the point to go to him and say, ud'u Allah li? He would have stayed at home, wherever he is, and said, O Allah, I turn to you through your Prophet Muhammad, the Prophet of mercy, O Muhammad, blah, blah, until the end of hadith, and he would have been done. Why did he go to the Messenger of Allah and say, ud'u Allah li, ask Allah? And Prophet said, in shi'ta da'awtu, like, if you will, I will supplicate Allah for you. And if you remain patient, it is better. Why would they have this conversation? If that tawassul was valid, what does that prove? The whole thing was revolving around what again? Dua. That's the first refutation. Otherwise, he wouldn't need to go home. He wouldn't need to go to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He would remain at home and his case would be closed. طيب. Secondly, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam promised him to make dua. In shi't da'awtu Allah lak. If you will, I will make